Chapter 3, Vehicles. Vehicles are used in bandit games in one of three ways, each of which is described below. Quick, off-camera transportation. You want to get the characters from one adventure site to another. It's easy to simply say, you board a sailing ship and the drunken pilot.
Represent the wheel size of the vehicle any more than a D&D
how far behind the horse is monetary. Rotation point. Each vehicle diagram shows a rotation point for selling ships. It's usually the primary mass. Whenever the vehicle turns, keep the rotation point stationary and pivot the vehicle around the point to make the turn. The driver position. Whether it's a ship helm, a mass of levers and dials, or just a convenient place to grab the reins, there's one spot where the driver of the vehicle stands or sits. That's the driver position shown on the diagram. If the driver leaves this position, the vehicle is out of control. See out of control vehicles later in this chapter. 10 feet sections. Vehicles with a longest dimension, length or height of 20 feet or more have their exteriors divided into 10 feet square sections to handle combat damage. Each section has its own armor class, hit points, and hardness. The destruction of a 10-foot section doesn't necessarily mean the demise of the vehicle, but it's rarely good news for the crew. Sailing ships also have rigging, which is treated as its own section separate from the 10-foot section that make up the hull. Attackers can't target the rigging separately. Attackers can target the rigging separately using the statistics provided with each vehicle. Behind the scenes, physics and vehicles. This book is not and cannot be a physics textbook, a pilot's manual, or a set of sea captain's charts. This is our best simulation of vehicle movement to combat within the D&D rules. Don't be surprised if sailing vessels don't work exactly the way they do in the real world, or if hand gliders don't take drag into account and minimize the effects of gravity. Interior features. Much like a dungeon, particularly large vehicles have interior walls, hallways, doors, and other architectural features. Space is generally at a premium on a vehicle, so such features tend to be smaller and more cramped than their stationary counterparts. But in a world with magic, almost anything is possible, and eventually the line between massive vehicles and mobile buildings become indistinguishable. Driver. Throughout this chapter, the term driver denotes the person who is directly responsible for vehicle's actions. This person might be a wagon driver, a galley's coxswain, or a zeppelin's pilot. The driver might use different skills depending on the vehicle. A dog sled musher uses handle animal on all their maneuver checks, while a zeppelin pilot uses profession pilot on his. Proper skill names are used where appropriate, but profession appears as a generic term to avoid clumsy redundancy. Anywhere profession stands alone without a specific profession. profession, skill, preferred use, and or animal, or a profession skill appropriate to the vehicle being discussed. Maneuverability, much like flying, characters and creatures, all vehicles, not just air vehicles, have maneuverability attributes. The land and water-based vehicles, the only characteristics affected by maneuverability are turn in place and maximum turn. Land and water-built vehicles can't climb or dive. They don't have minimum forward speeds. Water vehicles use new nautical maneuverability categories. See Table 3.1 for a summary of all characteristics affected by maneuverability. Those characteristics are explained and defined below. Minimum forward speed. If an air vehicle fails to maintain its minimum forward speed, it must land at the end of its current move. If it is too high above the ground to land, it falls straight down, descending 100 feet in the first round of failing. If this brings it to the ground, it takes falling damage. If the fall doesn't bring it to the ground, the vehicle must spend its next turn recovering from the stall. It must succeed on a reflex saving throw DC 20 to recover. Otherwise, it falls another 300 feet. If it hits the ground, it takes falling damage. If not, it has another chance to recover on its next turn. However, the ability of an air vehicle to stay in one place while airborne, fly backwards. The ability of the air vehicle to fly backwards. Reverse. Vehicle with good maneuverability uses up 5 feet of its speed to start moving backwards. No matter what their maneuverability is, wind-powered vehicles can't go in reverse. Gray creatures move backwards at a speed of 10 feet in their normal speed, whichever is less. Four-powered vehicles move backwards at half speed. Turn, how much the vehicle can turn after covering the stated distance. Turn in place. The vehicle with good or average maneuverability can spend some of its speed to turn in place. Maximum turn, how much the vehicle can turn in any one space. Up angle. The maximum angle at which an air vehicle can climb. Up speed. How fast an air vehicle can climb. Down angle. The maximum angle at which an air vehicle can descend. Down speed. An air vehicle can fly down at twice its normal flight speed. Between down and up, an air vehicle with average poor or clumsy maneuverability must fly level for a minimum distance after descending and before climbing. Any air vehicle can begin descending after a climb without an intervening distance. For simplicity's sake, vehicles turn in 45-degree increments. When a vehicle turns, simply pivot it around its rotation. rotation point. If a turn puts the vehicle on top of other creatures, what happens depends on the relative size of the vehicle and the creatures. Treat the vehicle as a creature of its size. If it's three or more size categories larger than creatures in its way, it can turn right, blue, air, squares. It comes up much more rarely, but the vehicle three or more size categories smaller than a creature can also run through the creature's area or turn through the creature's area. If the creatures are three size categories smaller than the vehicle can't make a turn through their areas. If you're trying to collide with someone on purpose, you need to move, not turn into its space. See collision below. Driving a vehicle is generally a move of woodland action. Vehicle takes a single or double move on the driver's initiation count, turning as the driver wishes. Driver is free to attack, cast a spell, or perform another standard action in addition to driving. Most vehicles have a maximum speed. This is the greatest distance it can cover in a single move, and undamaged vehicle can make a double move as easily as a single move. Propulsion. Vehicles have two basic types of propulsion. If vehicles are powered either by creatures such as a horse-drawn car or a human-powered longship, or by an inanimate force such as wind, gravity, or mechanical power. Some vehicles, such as ships, have a choice in either type of propulsion, using oars or sails. Table 3-1, vehicle maneuverability. Minimum forward speed, perfect 9, good 9, average half, poor half, clumsy half, nautical good 9, nautical average 9, nautical poor 9, dirigible 9, hover, perfect yes, good yes, average no, poor no, clumsy no, nautical good slash, nautical average slash, nautical poor slash, dirigible none, yes, fly backwards, perfect yes, good yes, average no, poor no, clumsy no, nautical good slash, nautical average slash, nautical poor slash, dirigible yes, reverse, perfect 3, good -5, feet average slash, poor slash, clumsy slash, nautical good slash, nautical average slash, nautical poor slash, dirigible slash, turn perfect in good 90 degrees slash 5 feet average 45 degrees slash 5 feet poor 45 degrees slash 5 feet clumsy 45 degrees slash 10 feet nautical 45 degrees slash 30 feet nautical average 45 degrees slash 60 feet nautical place. Perfect in good plus 90 degrees / negative 5 feet. Average plus 45 degrees / negative 5 feet. 4. No. Clumsy. No. Nautical good special. Maximum term, perfect any, good any, average 90 degrees, 45 degrees, clumsy 45 degrees, nautical good 45 degrees, nautical average 45 degrees, nautical 45 degrees, dirigible / up.
Percentage 100 and condition wind storm.
or per day, 75 to 150 miles. Windstorm, 51 to 74 miles per hour. Hurricane, 75 to 150 miles per hour. Speed multiplier, cancel. Table 3-3, random wind direction. DA-1, wind direction. Originating direction, south. DA-2, wind direction, originating direction, southwest. DA-3, wind direction, originating direction, west. DA-4, wind direction, originating direction, northwest. DA-5, wind direction, originating direction, north. DA-6, wind direction, originating direction, northeast. DA-7, wind direction, originating direction, east. DA-8, wind direction, originating direction, southeast. As long as the vehicle is pointed within 90 degrees of downwind, its maximum speed is equal to the speed given to the vehicle statistics. Block modified, multiplied by the speed multiplier from table 3-2 above. For example, if a moderate wind is coming from the south, a gallery with a speed of 20 feet heading west, northwest, north, northeast, or east has a speed of 40 feet, 20 feet times 2. If a wind-powered vehicle turns so that its bow points within 45 degrees of the direction the wind is coming from, its speed is reduced by half as long as it's heading in that direction. For example, if the wind is coming from the south, a galley heading southeast or southwest might move at half speed. If a wind-powered vehicle turns into the wind, its bow points in the direction the wind is coming from, it comes to a halt and it ends its movement that round. The vehicle can spend one of its move actions to rotate 45 degrees in either direction, which will get it moving in at half speed until it turns to more favorable winds. This is why the special entry on table 3-1 refers to 4-powered vehicles. Vehicles with rollers move more consistently as long as enough rollers are present. 4-powered vehicles move at their given speed at any direction. Furthermore, they tend to be more maneuverable in close quarters than vehicles that rely on sails. If the indicated number of rollers isn't available, reduce the vehicle speed by the same percentage as the reduced crew. For example, a galley that ordinarily has a speed of 20 feet with 160 rollers has a speed of 10 feet. If only 80 rollers are aboard, ships generally need at least one quarter of the indicated number of rollers ships, with ores and sails. Some vehicles, such as the galley and the warship, have both ores and sails. 2 maneuverability ratings and 2 speeds are given. The driver of the vehicle decides whether it is using rowers or sails for locomotion. The method of locomotion can be changed in as little as 1 round. Drawn vehicles. The speed of a drawn vehicle, such as a wagon or chariot, depends on what's pulling it. The dray creature. Horses are the most common dray creatures, but the world of D&D game also features carriages pulled by dire wolves, sea sleds propelled by orcas, and vast sea scours drawn by tons of war elephants. 2 factors determine the speed of a drawn vehicle: the weight of the vehicle and the strength score of the dray creature. First, figure out the total weight of the vehicle, including driver, passengers, and cargo. Then divide the weight by 4 if it's a wheeled vehicle, or by 3 if it's an ice sled or water vehicle. The result is the full weight of the vehicle. Next, compare the pull weight of the vehicle to the strength score of the dray creature on table 9-1. Carrying capacity on the in the player's handbook to find out how fast the vehicle can travel. If there are several dray creatures, simply divide the weight among them. For example, Ida has commandeered a treasure-laden wagon pulled by 2 heavy horses. The wagon weighs 400 pounds and it holds 3,750 pounds of treasure. And Ida weighs 50 pounds, including her gear. That means the wagon's total weight is 4,200 pounds, and its pull weight is 1,050 pounds. 2 heavy horses therefore carry 525 pounds each. Heavy horses have strength 15 and as large quadrupeds. They carry 3 times the weight given in Table 9-1. This means they are under a heavy load, so the vehicle moves at a speed of 35 feet, and the horses can't run. Once you know the pull weight of the vehicle, it's easy to figure out how the death of one dray creature affects the vehicle. The other dray vehicle in a team might be strong enough to pick up the slack once the dead creature is released from the harness, but they also might be unable to move the vehicle at all. Controlling drowned vehicles in combat. Controlling drawn vehicles in combat. 4 horses, 4 ponies, and other creatures trained for battle serve readily as dray creatures in a fight. Other creatures tend to be frightened by combat. If the check, vehicle functions normally. The driver, he fails, must spend the rest of the round trying to calm the great creature and can't take any other actions. Drivers who need both hands to fight and try to control a drawn vehicle with verbal commands by wrapping the reins around an arm or by using some other makeshift technique, but it's difficult. A handle animal tech EC25 is required at the beginning of the round. You try this. If you fail, you can either pick up the reins, dropping something in one hand, or choose to let the vehicle be out of control this round. See out of control vehicles below. Controlling vehicles. Driving a vehicle under good weather conditions with sufficient food requires no check, no skill checks. It is a land-based vehicle. You don't have to make a skill check just to drive along the road. If the weather is foul, the terrain treacherous, or your vehicle short-handed, you must make skill checks every round to keep your vehicle under control. Table 3-4 Vehicle Control DCs identify some common situations requiring vehicle control checks. Table 3-5 Vehicle Control DCs ask, drive in precipitation, DC 10, drive during storm, DC 20, drive during powerful storm, DC 30, drive on times 3/4 terrain, mountain, highway, jungle, road, swamp, swamp road, hill road, trackless scrub, DC 10, ask, drive on times half terrain, mountain road, trackless forest, swamp, hills, or desert, DC 20. Ask, drive on times 1/4 terrain, trackless, jungle, mountains, DC 30. Ask, sail in white seas, DC 5. Ask, sail in moderate seas, DC 15. Ask, sail in heavy seas, DC 25. Ask, less than full crew, DC 10. Ask, less than half crew, DC 20. Ask, less than 1/4 crew, DC 30. Each vehicle statistics block gives the relevant skill. Almost always handle animal for land-based vehicles or profession sailor for waterborne vehicles. If the driver doesn't have the relevant skill, the vehicle remains stationary. If it didn't move the previous round, or is out of control, if it didn't move, see out of control vehicles below. If conditions require a control check, the driver makes checks every round on tactical movement scale, every minute on the local scale, and every hour on the overland scale. If a driver fails a vehicle control check, what happens depends on the current movement scale. Overland movement. A land vehicle is reduced to half speed for 1 hour if the driver by 5 points or more means that no progress is made in the next hour. Minor breakdowns, stuck wheels, and uncooperative brake readers count for many of these delays. Consequences of failure are the same for waterborne and airborne vehicles, with one additional consideration. If the control check fails by 10 or more, the vehicle is sent off course in a random direction. Use Table 3-3 to determine direction. The vehicle moves in the direction for 1 hour at its maximum speed. Local movement. All vehicles move at half speed for 1 minute if the control check fails by 1 through 4 points. They make no progress at all for 1 minute if the check fails by 5 points or more. Tactical movement. If conditions require a control check, the driver makes one immediately when it's his turn. If the check fails, roll on one of the following two tables, depending on the degree of failure. Table 3-5, failed control check 1 through 4 points. D6-1, result, vehicle can't move this round. D6-2-4, result, vehicle moves at half speed this round. D6-5-6, result, vehicle is considered one maneuverability rating worse this round. Table 3-6, held control check, 5 plus points, D6-1, result, vehicle can't move until repairs are made, D6-2, result, vehicle turns as if it can, in a random direction each time, at last round speed. D6-3, result, vehicle must turn left as soon as possible, thereafter functions normally. D6-4, result, vehicle must turn right as soon as possible, thereafter functions normally. D6-5, result, vehicle drives straight ahead at maximum speed. D6-6, result, vehicle can't move this round. Out of control vehicles. Sometimes a driver is incapacitated or leaves the wheel, voluntarily or otherwise. If that happens, the vehicle is out of control. The driver's initiative count, roll on table 3-6 above to determine how the vehicle moves. Unless the result indicates a turn, the vehicle continues straight ahead. An out of control vehicle continues to roll on table 3-6 every round until it comes to a stop from a result on the table or a collision. See collision below. Vehicle combat uses the normal rules described in Chapter 8 of the Player Handbook. Vehicles have maneuverability just as flying characters and creatures do, have limitations on how quickly they can turn. They generally provide at least a measure of cover described in the individual vehicle description. Driving a vehicle is a move equivalent action, so driving can generally make a single attack while driving. Passengers on a vehicle can make attacks normally, but it's sometimes hard to fight aboard a moving vehicle, a vibrating vehicle. It's also possible to run into a foe with your vehicle. Such collisions represent an unusual attack type. See collision below for more information. Melee attacks. If the vehicle moves more than 5 feet in a round, the driver and passenger can each only make a single melee attack. Essentially, you have to wait until your vehicle gets to the enemy before attacking, so you can make a full attack. If you attack a melee size or smaller creature who's standing on the ground, you get a +1 bonus on the attack roll for being on higher ground. Ranged attacks. Normal range attacks and siege engine attacks made from a water vehicle incur a -2 penalty during inclement weather. A -4 penalty during a storm, and a -8 penalty during a powerful storm, because the waves cause the ship's deck to pitch, making such attacks difficult. These penalties stack with any penalties from high winds. See table 317. Wind effects in the Dungeon Master's Guide. As with mounted combat, you are assumed to make your attack rolls when the vehicle is at midpoint of its movement for that round. Casting a spell casters aboard a moving vehicle must succeed in concentration checks to cast spells. The check DC is 10 plus spell level for all land vehicles and for air or water vehicles in inclement weather. The check DC is 15 plus spell level aboard an air or water vehicle in a storm, and 25 plus spell level in a powerful storm aboard a big air or water vehicle. A spellcaster can reduce the check DC by 5 by going below decks. Fighting drivers. A driver can voluntarily relinquish control of a vehicle to make a full attack or take another full round action. Such a vehicle is out of control, see above, until the driver spends a move equivalent action to bring the vehicle under control again. Collisions. If you hit something with your vehicle, whether internationally or by accident, at full speed, the collision deals the ram damage given in the vehicle statistics block. Your vehicle or the 10-foot section, including the ram, if a big vehicle takes an equal amount of damage. For example, if you try to run down a pedestrian who has 17 hit points, your double chariot can't take more than 7 points of damage, no matter how fast you're going. Some vehicles have extra braces and heavy striking surfaces that make them better at ramming. Vehicles with rams take only half damage for collisions they initiate. The given damage is for a vehicle traveling at maximum speed. If a vehicle can't reach its maximum speed due to terrain, damage, or other factors, adjust the damage dealt by the same proportion as the speed. For example, a double chariot that could ordinarily deal 4d6 points of damage in a ram deals only 2d6 points of damage on a mountain road because it's limited to half speed there. Vehicles don't need to actually move a distance equal to their speed to make a full damage ram attack. They need only move 10 feet in a straight line. The given ram damage assumes that the vehicle is hitting a more or less stationary target, but it's the relative speed between the ramming vehicle and the target that matters most, not the ramming vehicle's actual speed. If a sailing ship with a wind aim speed of 60 feet rams the stern of a long ship being rowed at a speed of 15 feet, the ram deals only 96 points of damage, not 12d6, because the sailing ship is effectively moving at a speed of 45 feet relative to the long ship's, or 3/4 of its maximum speed. But if the long ship and the sailing ship have a head-on collision, the sailing ship deals 15d6 points of damage because it's effectively moving at 75 feet, 1 1/4 times its maximum speed relative to the long ship. Oblique angles. If your vehicle collides with another vehicle at an angle that is neither head-on, perpendicular, nor the same, treat the collision as if the angle were the nearest 90-degree angle. In other words, a collision counts as head-on, adding the speed together. Even if one vehicle is moving north and the other vehicle is bearing a few degrees off south, if it's exactly a 45-degree angle, one vehicle is going east and the other is going northeast, for instance. Use the most damaging category. Thus, if a vehicle going east rams one, going northeast, use the ramming speed of the eastbound vehicle to figure ramming damage. If a vehicle going east rams one going southwest, add their speed together to figure out the ramming damage. Creatures and stationary objects such as walls, shoals, and fruit carts take damage as normal, accounting for harness or damage reduction first. To apply damage to a vehicle, see attacking a vehicle below. If the collision destroyed whatever you hit, you may continue moving at half speed. If it's still there, your vehicle stops for the rest of the round. Collision and passengers. Driver, crew, and passengers in smaller vehicles are all vulnerable to damage in a collision. All aboard a vehicle that comes to a stop after a collision takes 1d6 points of damage per 10 feet of relative speed in the collision. A successful reflex save DC 20 halves the damage if the vehicle is huge or larger. Those aboard take damage only if the collision destroys the vehicle. Leaving a moving vehicle, whether you jump or get pushed, sometimes you leave the vehicle while it's moving. Hitting the ground deals 1d6 points of damage per 10 feet of speed. Reflex half DC 20. Regardless of the save result, such a character is prone unless she succeeds on a tumble check. DC 15 plus 1 per 10 feet of speed. Drawn vehicles and collisions. An inattentive captain. An inattentive captain can easily sail a ship into a dead, but even the worst charioteer can't drive a team of horses into a brick wall. When confronted with